Hello, welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at how to draw this shape here and this specific gradient. Now, this first looks like a simple radial gradient, but it's not. So let's select it. And in the upper left, you see it's a mesh. It's a gradient mesh. Now, you could say, okay, so but why don't I just use a radial gradient? Because it simply looks like it. In this case, yes, of course, you could use a radial gradient, and that would be the simplest method to do this. But maybe you want to later create this kind of thing. And this couldn't be created with just radial gradients, and it would also be quite difficult using freeform gradients. But it's the basically the same thing as the other one, so this one. Now, when you use a mesh on a circle, then you don't get this. Now, when you just have a circle and then apply a mesh to this, and I'm going to use Object and create gradient mesh, like so, and you see you don't get this specific mesh. Now, when I select the center point in here and make this white, then you see, well, not quite. Let's take a look at this one. It looks like this. And this is the typical gradient mesh, which has the corner points like in here and there. So these are the corner points of the mesh. We can select one of them and you see this is actually a corner point. But how do we get this one? Now, let's first take a look at how it's built. So when I select this point here and move it, then you see what has been done. So the mesh has been bent into a circle. Of course, you can do that manually, but it's quite a lot of work and you probably won't end up with a really exact circle shape. So let's take a look at the simple method. To do this, you start with a circle, or you can also start with any other kind of shape. So let's do it like this, and then you apply a gradient to that. Let's take the gradient panel and just click on the gradient, which is already a circular gradient. But if it's not, you can just change it here, radial gradient, like so. And then you go to Object, Expand. And in there, usually it's set to specify, and you want it to create a gradient mesh, and click on OK, like so. So this hasn't changed a lot. We can close this here, and then let's get further on. You see, when you select it, it's a group, it's not a mesh. So what gives? Let's go to Window Layers, and in the layers, you see here is the group, and let's drill down, and there is the mesh. We can just get it out of here and get rid of the group, like so. And there we have our mesh. And then you can continue working with it. So you can use the mesh tool and create more mesh lines on it. And of course, you can take the direct selection tool to select them and move them around. And one thing is these points here. So we've seen it's not one, it's actually two stacked on each other. So if you want to color them in the same color, what you need to do is either go into Outline View so that you can select them. So you go into Outline View and then you can take the direct selection tool and select them both to give them the same color. Or if you don't want to do that, then you can also take the lasso tool. So when you know where they are, you can take the lasso tool to just circle them and then apply a color to them. So let's close the layers here and check out the color. And you see they get the same color and then it looks like it's just one point. So that's how you create this special gradient mesh.